Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattle Essence. Welcome back to another video. I hope you're all doing well. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you for joining me this evening. And in today's video, I'm very excited to be sharing with you my thoughts on a fragrance by Nishane Istanbul. I do realize that this one is a few years old now, but this one is called Fan Your Flames. So make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I begin my fragrance review of Fan Your Flames by Nishane, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content, if you like fragrance reviews just like this, but also top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, and more, please do support this channel by subscribing to it. I'm trying to reach 150,000 subscribers. I would really appreciate it if you could help me reach that milestone. And 60% of you who watch this channel are not subscribed to this channel, so it would help tremendously if you would subscribe. And then, of course, while you're at it, make sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell icon as well. So Nishane is such a powerful niche company, and this is a brand that's been around for a few years now. As a matter of fact, this fragrance in specific has been around since 2016. I believe the perfumer is Jorge Lee. Don't quote me on that, but he has done many fragrances for Nishane. I've actually also had the pleasure of meeting him in person a couple of times when I made a trip to Istanbul, Turkey, such an amazing destination. And of course, I got to smell a lot of his creations. And I know when it comes to Nishane, some of the more popular fragrances are like Ani, which was made by Cecile Zarokian. There's also Hachivat and a number of other fragrances that have achieved almost like God-tier status in the community. But this is a fragrance that often flies under the radar, and I find that it is a hidden gem, especially if you are a fan of boozy, rum, tobacco, coconut, vanilla, and earthy types of fragrances. This has a note breakdown that will make you salivate. So this is definitely one of my favorite fragrances. And I do want to mention that if you are interested in purchasing this fragrance or getting a sample of it, you may do so at fragranceusa.com. This video is being shot in collaboration with them. A lot of really hard to find niche and designer fragrances for fantastic prices. All of the information is going to be down below. So I'm excited to tell you what I get in terms of the smell. Let's start things off with the presentation. I do apologize for not having the box for this presentation, but I did acquire this fragrance a very long time ago, and so I don't have the box on hand. I do apologize. But here's the bottle. You may have noticed that they have since changed their caps. This is some of their old caps. The new ones have a bit more of a unique shape to them. They're not entirely cylindrical. And you just have a label here on the front with the name of the fragrance and the name of the company. There's nothing going on at the bottom, nothing going on at the back. The cap for this fragrance is a snug fit, so you can pick it up from the cap. And the distribution on the atomizer is a little bit narrow, but it gets the job done. Let's continue with the smell. So right in the opening of this fragrance, it opens up very boozy, warm, rich, sweet, spicy, and resinous. Now, I know I mentioned a lot of things in that description and a few adjectives that are not necessarily listed in the note breakdown. Like, where are the resins, for example, right? When I looked at the note breakdown, I couldn't find any such resins that would smell the way that this one smells. And so I'm picking up on a little benzoin, right? So it has this vanillic overtone. It's a little smoky. It's a little dark. A piece of me feels like that darkness or that touch of smoke or earthiness is probably coming from the patchouli, but I'm also convinced that there is something else lurking underneath here, maybe a little bit of cade, maybe a little bit of, birch tar, something of that nature. But what I'm getting the most of in the opening is this really delightful vanilla. And it's a spicy vanilla. You have a little bit of cinnamon. You have some darker spices in here as well. But then you also have this boozy coconut thing happening in the opening, which is just absolutely addictive and amazing. This fragrance is in the vein of Herod by Parfum de Marly. So if you are a fan of the DNA of Herod, there's a very good chance you're going to like this one because it does utilize a lot of the same notes. It's kind of like one of these sweetened tobacco ingredients, if you will. So you are going to get a lot of that in here, but the booze in combination with the coconut kind of reminds me of, and I think this is Parfum de la Nuit 2 by Roja Parfum. That is a fragrance that has booze or rum specifically, if I'm remembering correctly, but also coconut. And it's on the gourmand side. So you have that undercurrent of vanilla that really bolsters up the other notes. And What I can say about this one is that it's a complex scent. It's a little bit on the daring side. It's not overly smoky. I know I mentioned smoke, but it's not overly smoky to the point where it becomes unwearable or a little bit too uncomfortable when you wear it. No, you can definitely pull this off with ease, especially in the colder months. Now, I believe today's date is January 25th, and so I've had this in my possession for a few years now. This was not sent to me by the company, but this is a fragrance that I absolutely love and adore, hence the reason why I felt the need to add it to my collection. So it opens up very boozy, warm, rich, spicy, vanillic, a little smoky, definitely having that fruity emphasis with the coconut in the opening. And all I can say is if you are a fan of fragrances like Parfum de la Nuit 2 by Roja Parfum or Herod by Parfum de Marly, there's a strong chance that you will love this one. A job well done by Nishane Istanbul. This is definitely one of their best creations, and I am surprised at how under the radar this one does fly. Let's go ahead and finish things off with my overall assessment. So first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, I know I compared it to a few other fragrances throughout the course of this description here on this video, but it doesn't necessarily smell exactly like Herod. It doesn't smell exactly like Parfum de la Nuit 2. It just sort of has elements of those two fragrances, and it would be appropriately worn for the same occasions. And so basically, if you're familiar with the DNAs of those fragrances and you like those fragrances, there's a very strong chance, like a 98% chance, that you're also really going to enjoy Fan Your Flames. In terms of the overall smell, very appealing aroma, very intriguing aroma, intriguing and enticing. But again, it's not like a mass marketed freshie, so it's not the type of DNA that's going to appeal to everybody. It's a little bit more on the daring side, so definitely make sure you sample this one before you commit to purchasing a full bottle, unless of course you are a fan of those other fragrances that I mentioned earlier. In terms of the longevity on this one, the longevity is about 8 or 9 hours. It does last a very, very long time on my skin. I also do have one of the original presentations from the brand. As you may have probably noticed, the cap has changed, and so this has been left to macerate for a very long time. You can see the liquid inside is very dark, so the longevity on this particular bottle is about 9 or 10 hours. It lasts a very long time. Projection is great for the first hour and a half. It didn't start to sit closer to the skin until about that 7, 7.5 hour mark, but fantastic projection and longevity, really above par. In terms of the versatility, I think this one is great for the colder weather. I wouldn't wear this one in the summer. I find that it's perfectly unisex. A lot of people who consider tobacco and oak moss to be masculine ingredients will probably argue otherwise. They'll say that this one is masculine leaning, but again, I find all fragrances to be genderless. Pretty much wear what makes you happy, wear what you like. And I do think that this one is probably better suited for somebody who's a little bit older, and I would definitely wear this during a special occasion. In terms of the presentation, I think it's very nice, everything from the name to the label, and I know the cap has received a bit of an upgrade, but my final verdict on this fragrance is if you are looking for an under the radar hidden gem type of a fragrance for the colder weather and you want to get it for a really good price, you may do so at fragranceusa.com. This is a fantastic combination of rum, spices, vanilla, coconut, oak moss, and a touch of smoke underneath it all, with that vanilla really, you know, pushing up the other ingredients. It's an amazing fragrance, one of my favorites from the company Nishane Istanbul, and one of my top 5 favorites from the brand, hands down. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for your time and thank you for tuning in. I really hope that you enjoyed this video and that you took something of value from this video. I do want to say that if you are new to this channel again and you took something of value, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. And while you're at it, make sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. Thanks again for watching. I love you all and we'll see you soon.